What's up, guys, and welcome back to Planet 2. My oh my, do we have some exciting new updates to go over. So in our last episode, obviously, we built the saltwater crocodile habitat, and they're doing really well. They're over here just kind of hanging out. They're enjoying themselves and just kind of floating and doing their thing. But we had a couple other things happen. So if you guys remember, one of our African buffalo died. I think one of the aardvarks died, and then also a couple of the African wild dogs died. So I went into the marketplace, and I was just trying to find ones to be able to fix this. We actually finally found a male African buffalo. I think this is him right here, Chionisu. And you guys can see he's actually significantly smaller than each of the females in here, but it looks like he's kind of eyeing down Adama right here, which would be kind of nice. The African buffalo are pretty, like, prominent. Like, a lot of people want to see them. They bring a lot of hype to the zoo, and the fact that we might be able to start breeding is kind of exciting. Now, you guys may notice we actually did have to expand their pen because of the increased number of them. So I kind of moved this whole side of the zoo out more. In turn, our aardvarks now have a little bit more space, which I guess is good. It wasn't necessary, but it was primarily just to make sure that these African buffalo are happy. And when we did that, we couldn't keep our same plant thing going on because we couldn't add any more plants because it was gonna become too much for them, too much coverage. So instead, I added some vines along the edges of the fence, which I think looks pretty nice, at least nicer than just plain barren wooden fences. And then we put this new tree in the back. So I feel like overall they look pretty good. You guys can see we are at a 91% welfare. Interspecies bonus is the only thing that's missing there, as well as food enrichment. Can we actually, we might be able to help that out a little bit. I'm gonna go to habitat here. We're gonna change this up to the African buffalo. And food enrichment, is this a forage box? That's a mud bath. We could put a mud bath in here. They may like that. So I'm gonna put a mud, where should we put it? Maybe over here? I'm trying to find a good place to put it. I guess right there, we could put a mud bath there, and then a hanging grazer feeder. We could put a hanging grazer feeder. We could put that right over here like this in front of the window so people can watch it. So that should help out. Yeah, that brought the welfare up a couple of percent. So that's pretty solid. One other thing we did, and I did it like just because I wanted something new over here. I kind of regret it. I feel like in the future I need to make sure that I'm always recording it when I do this kind of stuff, like these little zoo upgrades. I didn't think we were going to go this intense, but we set up a new shopping center. So when I went into zoo, you can actually see in your finances or facilities, you could see which restaurants had like high demand and low demand and etc. And Gulpy had a very high demand. Like, it was bad. We didn't have enough Gulpies. So I knew we needed a second Gulpy. And then I thought, like, you know, typically if you walk in a zoo, some of the first things you're gonna want are a drink and a snack. So we have a Gulpy right here, as well as a hot dog place and this little double storefront type thing. And then because, oop, spot fine for an injured animal. That sucks. But because hot dogs, drinks, they may want a little place to rest, I made like a little picnic table area here, which is kind of nice. We surrounded it with the elephant grass, so you can't really see like the generator and stuff back there. And I feel like it turned out pretty well. So that's really the major difference here. We added a few new animals in each of the exhibits, as well as set up that new little food area there. So now we need to talk about what we're gonna do for our next animal exhibit. What do we want to get into here? I'm honestly not sure. So I'm going to go into our animal market. I'm going to set it up so it's cash only listings. And I'm going to refresh it here. If it's going from like the most exciting things to the least exciting, it looks like hippos, mandrills, black bears, grizzly bears, aardvarks are actually really high up there. That's kind of crazy. Hyenas, macaques, timber wolves, ring-tailed lemurs. A lot of these are pretty solid. Some zebras in there, Nile monitors. Trying to see, springbok, wildebeest. We could try to build a big wild Africa thing. Let me see this for a second. If we do have these guys, what can they get along with? Where do you see their, I think we gotta go to their Zoopedia. Interspecies enrichment. So if we have wildebeest, giraffe, sable antelope, springbok, plain zebras, things like that, we're gonna be able to put all of these guys together in one massive thing, which could be kind of cool. I wish there were... Oh, we've got a pregnant crocodile. That's what I'm talking about. That's very, very exciting. I think... Don't we have a pregnant... We might have a pregnancy over here. Let me check. Mashavu, are you pregnant? How do you tell if they're pregnant? Physical stats, lifetime stats. I'm pretty sure she's pregnant. I'm like 99% positive. She's a little older. You guys can see she's definitely towards the end of her life cycle, but I'm pretty sure she's pregnant. So we've got a couple of babies coming in, which is really exciting. But yeah, what do you guys think? Should we make... That's going to be kind of a big undertaking. We might want to wait for that, and we could send, like, this whole side. Just have this be, like, a huge African thing. I say we do that. Let's try to pick something for over here. I don't know what I want to do. I mean, the stats on these guys are pretty good. 9.6 years, a little older in the life cycle than I would prefer. How long do they live? Oh, 31 years. No, they've got plenty of time. All right, I'm going to set... Dude, should we do black bears? We haven't done black bears yet. Oh, shoot, we lost. Oh, no, they're here. Okay. I'm kind of tempted to do black bears. She's got longevity and fertility. I'm going to go ahead and adopt there. We've got this Formosan. His size isn't great. Fertility's pretty good, though. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get him. Now, let me check the Zoopedia. How many of these guys can we have? 1 to 2, one male and one female. So we've got them. All right, cool. We're gonna make a black bear exhibit. I'm kind of excited about this. I do think we need to do like a big African exhibit, but we need a lot of space for that. We need to kind of stockpile quite a few animals and stuff. It's gonna take some time to get that going. So we'll worry about that in the future, but I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna fast forward through the night here and I'll see you guys in a minute. He looks a little agitated. Is he just, he's just crawling around doing his thing. Enjoy. Cooper likes those little fountain things too. That's funny. But yeah, we're gonna skip through the night so we can see what's going on the next morning, and we're gonna get to work on a black bear exhibit. Oh, we've got babies! Oh my god, we got two babies! Two baby crocs! They're so cute! Are you kidding me right now? So this is Buddy. Oh, that's cute. So he's 0.1 years old, he's a male, and then this over here is Kaya. She's a female, also the same age, of course. They are cute, dude. Hold on, I wanna see him in action here. Let's go ahead and play this. I wanna see him swimming around, just doing little saltwater croc things. That evolution has been happening for so long, man. These guys were around when the dinosaurs were around. It's crazy to think that they're still kind of doing the same thing today. Just floating their way through life, eating their way through life, just kind of doing their thing. Let me see if our other baby has hatched. No. Not hatched, I guess. They're mammals. They're not hatching. I'm pretty sure she's pregnant. I'm almost positive that she's pregnant. I am really, really sad because she doesn't really have a mate here, like a friend, but she's old in her life cycle, so it'd be pointless to buy a new aardvark now. We're gonna let her live out her days in sorrow, and we're gonna get some new ones once she's long gone. But anyway, here we are. It's 11 in the morning. We are gonna move on to our next exhibit. And man, I'm thinking, what are you guys thinking? I'm thinking like a black bear exhibit, maybe right here. Could be kind of cool. I like that. So like we could have a path. We definitely don't need it that large. I'm gonna make it a 7.5-meter path, and we can have it run, oops, shoot. I want to make this longer. We can have it run down this way so that you can kind of see the backside of the crocs, which is kind of cool. And we could actually have it go, yeah, just like that. So you can kind of walk back a little bit. We could probably put a little bit of elephant grass here to be able to block that off. We let's just grab this and duplicate it. And then we can bring it over here and we can set this up so you can't, well, it's not necessary, but I guess we could. We can kind of bring this way. I just like the idea of cutting off the staff type areas. I think that's smart. I think that's important. So we can set that up like that. But yeah, so we've got that, and then I guess their little thing could be like in here. Try to think of, but then we have a lot of empty space over here that we aren't gonna use. We're gonna find a good space for them. I think we're gonna save this for the hippos. We're gonna keep aquatic animals over in the same area. But where do we wanna put these bears? I'm gonna bring it along like that. Boom, there we go. So we made a new kind of, cut a little area here. We could probably split this up into two or three exhibits. I feel like that looks pretty solid. To be honest, this thing is, oh shoot, I didn't mean to do that. This thing is probably a little bit pointless. So we're gonna take that off, and then we can just have the bear enclosure butt up against this to make maximum use of space. And hopefully it's still, I mean, we just, the problem is you can't go too deep, otherwise people aren't really gonna be able to see, so We've got to be very careful about that. I guess what we could do, hold on. Let's go back. We're going to put these back. We're going to bring that out like that, and then we're going to put a new path, and we could have this kind of cut around this way. That might be a little big, but no, it's going to be pretty solid. We could have this cut around this way, and then we could bring it back this way, and then we could put the bears in this cool little lips-looking area. I don't even know what else to say it, but then we could have another little area around here, so like we could set up the path. I like making fun, weird little paths, you know what I mean? So I want to have another path branch off, and we could go like this. And then bring it around this way, kind of like that. I don't want it to get too city blocky though, you know what I mean? Like we do have some curves here. I don't want it to be so that all of our things are in squares and they all line up perfectly with each other, but I feel like that's a solid way to do it there. I like that. All right, we're gonna work with it. We need to get that elephant grass back now though, cause we gotta block off this pathway. And we should probably have a little connection here. Where do we wanna put it though is the question. Cause people are lazy and otherwise people would just kind of walk across that as is. But yeah, I feel like that looks pretty good. We can even put another little connection like here. Ooh, I like that. That kind of, hold on. Something like that. Cause then they can access it from any which way, and it's not like you have to stop or you have to go around it really weird. I mean, we're obviously not like a city planner or anything. We don't really have to worry about the direction people are walking too hard. But I feel like overall that's a pretty good idea. So here we go. We are gonna move on. I'm gonna say let's use a wood log fence just cause that kind of makes sense for the bears. And we are going to send it around this way. We're gonna want something a little bit longer, and we are just gonna make a quick little enclosure. Just gonna bring this thing on around, right like so. We can extend it out, have it connect. Panel too long, what? Why does it say panel too long? What are you talking about? I guess we could have it go here and then put it on there. All right, weird. Boom, there it is. All right, so we've got that. Now I was thinking it would be kind of cool to add a little bit of height to it, but I guess we could just add a lot. We could add depth, if anything. We could do a lot of depth with water and then like little caves and stuff. If you guys remember from the beta, we did do one where we made the grizzly bears. They kind of had, was it the grizzly bears? Or was it the timber wolves? I think it might've been the timber wolves. Either way, we're gonna make sure it's good. So let me see this Zoopedia here. Let's see what we have, the black bear, right? What was it called? Formosan black bear. All right, so for the habitat, we need a grade 4 climb-proof fence. Oof. All right, that's more than I thought. So the logs are grade 3, red brick is grade 5, chain link, what's grade 4? I don't even see a grade 4. So I guess we're gonna have to go with the brick, but that, dude, that is ugly. We could put windows in it, but I really don't like that. I mean, we can make the windows big. I don't love that, but I guess we're just gonna have to go with, I don't, like the grizzly bears were nice, cause I'm pretty sure the grizzlies only, let me check the Zoopedia, they only need, they need grade 3, so the wood fence. No, it says they want a grade 4 as well. I might have to look this up. I feel like there's probably, what if we could combine two fences, like put a chain link in front of a wood fence or something? I'm not sure. I honestly don't know, but I guess we're gonna work with this. So let me make sure, we need to turn this into a habitat first of all. So let's go ahead and get a habitat gate. Where would we wanna put this? I guess they are closest to the what's it called? If it's like over here somewhere. I'm just trying to make it look nice. Yeah, something like that's pretty good. So we've got that. Unfortunately, we can't really hide the habitat gate here because people have a full 360 view of these things. You guys know we kind of tried to hide the habitat gate on this side off the main path. Here, we don't really have a choice. So that's just gonna have to be okay. So let's check this. This is gonna be 1,404 square meters. Now, if we bring up our Zoopedia, we're gonna go back to the Formosan black bear. We needed 950, so we are looking pretty good there. We need 40 square meters of climbing and to keep it from 0 to 40 degrees Celsius. So of course we are gonna have to come in and we are gonna need a cooler. So we're gonna put a cooler, maybe smack dab in the middle. Let's make sure, is that maxed out on distance? We might want two coolers. So I'm gonna move one here. Let's see how big that is. I'm gonna keep it about 20 degrees Celsius, and then I think we're gonna grab this. We're gonna put a second one over here to make sure the entire thing is covered. I guess we can hit play here and we'll keep an eye on the temperature. We could also, I mean, I guess we could just start bringing these guys in. We might as well. So we're gonna go to our trading, our storage, and we are gonna bring these two in. Oh, we've got another aardvark and another wild dog coming in too, which is good. Forgot about them. All right, so we're gonna put these two down in here. Looks good. And let's do our thing. Gonna increase the range on that bad boy a little bit, increase the range on this bad boy a little bit, and they should be good. This one can probably move it a little bit more in. Most of the habitat, I guess we probably could do a triangle setup. I guess we'll just see. We'll see what happens here. But here we go. We've got our black bears coming in for the first time. We've actually never seen these in this game, which is kind of exciting. So we're going to put them in here. We're going to see what they like. I know they're going to like bushes and berries and trees and grass and forests and stuff like that. He is not happy as of right now, of course. So the first thing we're going to do is we are going to set up our vets to start researching these guys on the Formosan black bear. We need to pretty much do everything else here too. So we're gonna want hard shelter, we're gonna build them a cave. They're gonna want better terrain. They want way more short grass. So let's bring out our terrain brush, make this thing pretty big. I'm gonna say let's start with a base of short grass. I think they're gonna want more short grass than anything. Base of short grass. So we got short grass all over the place. We gotta start thinking about how we want to kind of lay this thing out too. Like where we would've put their cave, where we would've put their water, if we wanna make a waterfall. I need to figure out how to make a waterfall, but yeah. All right, so we've got that. They could use a little bit more long grass and a little bit more soil, but that's pretty much it. So I'm thinking for a little cave, we could make something really cool. Hold on, let me see where the water treatment is. We're gonna have to create a new water treatment plant, so that's gonna be a problem. Since this side of the zoo is pretty much all covered, our next one's probably gonna wanna be out here or maybe out here. So I'm thinking water should probably go on this side. We're gonna have like a big pool of water, maybe a waterfall and something like that. And maybe we could have the cave over here, but we can make it so it's kind of a see-through cave. Like it's a big archway where they have some space. If we have to shut it off from the tourists, we can, but then that way people can still see them even when they're in the cave. And then we could do all their little toys and their food and stuff like that over on this side. So I guess let's put down some food and stuff first, of course. Plus, if this stuff is on this side, it's gonna be really easy for our keepers to get in there and take care of it. So that looks good. Looks like we already have some toys and stuff that they may like, but we're gonna worry about that afterwards. We're gonna wait on that, okay? So I'm gonna wait on the long grass and soil as well. Let's see what he actually likes. So Asia, tropical, temperate is what he wants. So we're gonna come into nature here and we're gonna go into tropical and temperate on the continent of Asia. And let's see, I guess as always, we're gonna start with our rocks. Let's take Asia off and we should be able to find some temperate rocks. What do you guys think? Tropical or temperate? Wait, they like tropical things? Typically they are in tropical places. You can find black bears in Florida. I just typically think of them up in like the Northeast and like Maine and stuff like that. But I'm gonna go temperate rocks because we haven't really used these yet. So what we're gonna do is we are gonna build a cool little cave type deal. And let's, I don't know, I'm just gonna go for it. Let's see what happens. Hopefully it turns out pretty well. And I'll let you guys know once we're done with it. What do you guys think about something like that? That's kind of cool, right? I'm trying to set all these in. Hopefully they can't use that to jump outside of the fence because that would not be good. But I feel like something like that looks pretty cool. Now, the question is it gonna count as hard shelter? Let me see under habitat. It does count as hard shelter. So that's kind of exciting. And it's something that like, I mean, we'll have to wait and see how they feel. I think in real life, an animal probably wants somewhere where they can go and hide away and not be seen by all the people looking through the glass. But at least in our zoo, you're gonna be able to see the bears at all times. So we've got this, and then we can come in and we can set up their bedding, and we can just kind of set this up like this. And I feel like it's gonna be a really fun little hangout spot for them. Now, I kind of want to make a waterfall. I just kind of don't know how to do it in this game. I feel like it's about time we learn because we're always talking about it, about how we want to do it. And I feel like there are gonna be more animals we're gonna wanna do it for. So if we're gonna do it, I mean, it'd be cool to have a waterfall come down here into a big pool that has like a little river this way or something. Now, technically the black bears, which by the way, he's a cutie, dude. I'm not gonna lie. I've just always liked bears, but black bears are, they're pretty cool. I've always been more of a grizzly bear fan, but black bears are cool. They don't really need any water. They need climbable area, which we're gonna put somewhere towards the middle. If they don't need water, it might not make sense. I just feel like it would be kind of cool. I'm gonna look it up real quick. Let me see if it's easily doable. There's a lot of videos on this. There's a lot of customization here. I wanna do it justice though. These videos are like 20 to 30 minutes. So I'm gonna hold off on that. We may come back and fix it up in the future, but for the sake of this episode, I don't wanna like stop and then restart. You know what I mean? I wanna keep the vibe going because I like where we're going so far. So we've got this. Now, obviously we know that he wants a little bit of a different terrain. He'd like a little bit more soil. So what we can do is I think we can just put soil underneath his little rock area. And then that kind of makes sense, whatever you would call it, just kind of the way it would be in real life. And then it also satisfies him. So there we go. We've got more soil almost to the point that he likes it. I guess we could kind of bring it around this way a little bit more and maybe on the back side. So that's pretty good. And then I guess we want a little bit more long grass. So we could put, where do we want to put the long grass? We could probably make like a little, what if we made like a little forest area over here? That could be kind of cool. So I'm gonna make some long grass over in this area. And it looks like he could use a little bit more soil instead of short grass. Depending on where we put the water, I guess we could put water over on this side. Let's make this all soil. And then we're gonna turn this into like a little pool type thing. So that should be good. He's pretty even across all of those. Looks like he's gonna be fairly happy. So overall, that's pretty good. Needs more social, needs more plants, and needs more enrichment, which we're working on. So in terms of plants, like we said, tropical and temperate. Let's come back into nature. We're gonna go with the tropical temperate in Asia. And let's see what we could do for plants. We've got cherry blossoms, we've got azaleas. Does he like azaleas? It's 1% on the coverage. He does kind of like those. I like those personally. So I'm gonna put these around this thing a little bit. I just think they're beautiful. They add a fair amount of color and I feel like they're good for us. We could even mask one of the coolers in it. Or actually let's move this. We're gonna move it more back into the rock and then we're gonna move the cooler underneath it. That looks pretty good. I like that a lot more. All right, so we've got those azaleas there. Banana palms are not gonna work. Ooh, we could do more of these. That could be kind of nice. You know, run it along here. Kind of get it back into the rock, just like that. Probably put one on this side as well. So we've got some azaleas, that's good. We've got broken cherry blossoms. Hold on, let me go back to where we can see him and see what he's thinking. We're at 7% coverage. He ideally wants to be at a lot more than that, for sure. Does he like these? Yes and no. So I'm gonna put one of these down somewhere. I guess we can keep it there. We've got cherry blossoms, lilies. Of course he's gonna like the big cypress trees and elm trees and stuff like that. Let me check this. Cypress isn't really doing it for him. He likes the bamboo. I didn't think they really liked bamboo, but I guess we can go with some bamboo. Kind of put one up on the rocks like this. Might be kind of cool. Could even put one over on this side. All right. That's not looking too bad. Himalayan birch tree. I feel like they've got to like birch trees. Trees I'm always so weird about because it's easy to overdo it. Kapok tree, 24%. He really likes that thing. But I think in general, he just wants more trees. I just don't, like, should we make like a really heavily wooded forest area over in this corner? Is that what we should go for? Because that could be kind of cool. These trees are just so freaking big, dude. I guess something like that could be interesting. I like that. That's gonna give us 18% coverage. So we're at a total of 25% so far. We need to get some blackberry bushes and stuff. Sycamore maples, twin flowers, wisterias. Where are all the berry bushes? Hold on a second. I'm gonna take all these off. I'm gonna look for berry bushes. Yeah, bearberry bush, cowberry or crowberry bush. I thought we had blackberry bushes as well, but like he's gonna like some bushes. Bears love bushes. We could give them some little bearberry bushes around back here just to kind of go foraging and get some berries and stuff. Might be kind of nice. Something like that. I guess he liked those. He likes those, but it's not really the same climate. Shoot. I mean, they look kind of cool, but if he doesn't like it, he doesn't like it. He likes this Bengal bamboo, so I might stick this back here, and we could kind of turn this into another little area for him to get away, kind of like I was mentioning. We could even grab these, and I mean, since you're not going to see anything anyway, let's just cut those off. We're going to take the windows off of this. No glass on those. And that way he kind of has his own little layer back here, and we could start kind of giving him quite a bit more. Cypress trees, I've got a feeling he's gonna like those. Let's see where that ends up on his list. 2%, nothing really too crazy. I like the ivy. Let me set this ivy up. We're gonna get it so it's nice and perpendicular. And then what we could do, trying to get it perpendicular. We could bring it around this way. We could maybe have the ivy kind of hanging from the rocks. Might be kind of interesting. Something like that. That's kind of cool, I guess. I like that. Kind of makes a little doorway for him. And he likes the ivy. I gave him 2%. I'm going to put some guilderose bushes around the base of this tree. I guess this kind of suits his fancy a little bit. We can do those and then delete that since there's no reason for that. I don't know. I mean, this is got vine curtains, nettle, mangroves, lots of nettle options. I mean, this is interesting. I guess this is kind of cool. I like this. This could give him something to maybe pick at and kind of, you know, get some berries and stuff. I'm not good with the tree. I feel like you could get so overcluttered so quickly. I'm always nervous about where I'm placing the trees, if that makes sense. We're getting there. We're up to 40% on the types of plants and 33% on the coverage. I say let's give them a little bit of different terrain. I'm gonna go to sculpting. And we're gonna give him kind of like a little, let's give him a little, oh shoot, that's coming up really, really quick. We probably need less intensity. Kind of want to give him a little hill to climb up on, maybe. Could put like a bush or something at the top of it. I just want to give him something to kind of run around on a little bit. So we've got that. We can go back into our nature. We could put, I mean, some of these big bushes might look nice there. Very odd bush here, but we could put like a bush on top. And then we could add maybe a little nettle around the outside. And then we definitely want a little bit of color in there. So I'm thinking, I mean, the guilderose, ooh, that's a big guilderose bush. That's kind of cool. We could set that up there. Let's get it a little better centered. Something like that. I think the thing underneath it isn't centered. So we could, and we're kind of cheating a little bit here. We're putting lots of bushes on top of each other, but that looks pretty cool. And then we could add, we could add some of these azaleas around just to give it a little more color pop. I just feel like that's a giant, I don't love it. That's a giant heap of bushes. Okay, we're gonna start with a better foundation there. And then I really like having a lot of bright, happy colors. So I think I'm just gonna make like a giant azalea bush out of multiple of them. I just feel like that looks pretty nice. And then we might even be able to put one of the white flowered bushes on top. Might be good. But I mean, they can run in there, they can forage around, and they can grab some berries and stuff out of that. What were the white bushes called? The guilderose bushes. Oh shoot, these are, the problem is they're so freaking big. Holy cow, but that's kind of cool because it's like a, yeah, it's like a tree coming out of the top of it. Okay. I respect that. Center it a little bit better. It's kind of hard to center, but that actually looks pretty solid there. Let me see where we're at with that. We're up to a 58% with 35% coverage. I think we could use a little bit more back here. Maybe those big ugly ones. What were those big ugly ones called? But he really, really liked those. They were just the plain green. I mean, hawthorn bushes wouldn't be bad, but that's not what I'm thinking about. Holly tree, these, the scaviola bushes. 4 meters, 8 meters, yeah. Do something like that. That's up to an 82% type of plants. Heck, we could do two of these kind of on top of each other, something like that. 83%, we're at 38% coverage. I mean, what else do you guys think? What if we made a tree grow out of a tree? Somehow life finds a way. So we're gonna put it in like that. I mean, that's kind of cool. I feel like this is starting to come together a little bit. And we need basically one more major thing. I mean, bracken. We could do some bracken over in the corner. We could do some bracken along here. Kind of give him a little bit more to forage through. We could run some through here as well. This is obviously kind of his center focal point is the cave. Or I guess there's gonna be more than just one bear. But yeah, we could do bracken all along here. I feel like that looks pretty solid. Not too shabby. We're up to 100% plant choice, but we need a little bit more coverage. I just feel like I like this area being a little more open. If anything, we could just put another tree over here, man. I mean, they like trees, obviously. They love to climb trees and stuff. So we're just gonna put another tree there and boom, there it is. We are good on the plants. I feel like it turned out pretty well so far. We actually don't have any water running yet, which we're gonna have to mess with. Technically, we don't need it. We might not need it though. I feel like black bears don't swim as much as grizzlies, but it still could be kind of interesting. I don't know. I'll let you guys decide on that and we'll add it later on if you guys want it. So let me see what else we need for him. We need climbable areas. So we're gonna come into habitat here and we need to build some things for them to climb on, which is a little bit dangerous. I'm gonna say we've got a long 6-meter log here. We've got platforms and all kinds of stuff. Can we take this and can we put it like this way and then make it so that they can climb up onto the top of the thing? Make it do something like that. I feel like that's pretty cool right there. If they could get up top, that's not gonna give them any climbable area. Let me see then if we take this. I want a flat thing, yeah. We could kind of set this up coming out of the rocks. I know it's kind of awkward, but I feel like it's pretty cool. Kind of making like a little dock thing come off of their little hibernation hut, but it's not actually counting as climbable area. Interesting. We need more enrichment. I'm wondering if as we do more research with these guys, we might, oh no, that's counting as climbable area. Okay, that's cool. We're up to 31 square meters. Nice. I didn't think it was working, but it is. So we can, I mean, it's kind of awkward, but it's kind of cool, I guess. I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna make it a little less intense. And then I wonder if we bring this up here, put it in like that, and then we might be able to bring it all the way to the ground. Perfection is key. Boom, that looks pretty good. That looks like one solid piece, and they could definitely climb up that. Is that gonna count as more climbable area? It's not. They're probably gonna want another piece that kind of juts out this way, which is fine. So we could, oh shoot. My shift button is kind of, oh, get it, bro, get it, nice. I'm gonna put that out like that. Sorry, he just got boxed up from me. We could put that like that. We could send it all the way back into the rocks, just like this. We can get rid of this, and then I think we can move this over here. I'm gonna try to line it up with that guy as much as I possibly can, bring it down a little bit, something like that is pretty good. All right, I like it, cool. So let's go ahead and unbox all animals here, and I think we're gonna be good to go. Social's not great. They want more space. They want more climbable space. We might have to do a little bit more research to be able to figure that out. They want 56 square meters of climbable space now. That's kind of odd. But yeah, we've got that going on. I wanna put some vines and stuff on this. I feel like the vines might look even better on that. Hold on, let me move this. If we put the vines on this, yeah, that's gonna be dope, dude. Put it up there like that. Oh man, that is sexy. I don't think I've ever called vines sexy before, but these vines are doing it for me. That, honestly, that is really, really cool. What do we have going on over here? We got a visiting player. I'm gonna go ahead and say hello, but I'm a little bit busy right now, fighting for alpha. Guests think the ticket prices are too cheap. That's fine, you keep thinking that. I'm gonna give you the best deal you've ever had. Bam, that's pretty good right there. I'm gonna go ahead and delete these under here. I feel like, actually, you know what? Those are pretty cool there as well. I'm gonna keep those hanging as well. I just have, oh shoot, I didn't mean to move it. Oh no, okay. The camera's freaking out on me. Yeah, keep him in there. I like that. Everything looks pretty good. These guys look pretty happy. But we need a little more enrichment, a lot more enrichment. And the temperature's not good. Why are the temps not working? What do we have the temps at? It says these guys like 0 to 40 degrees Celsius. I'm pretty sure we have it set pretty low. We might need another one of these. I'm gonna duplicate it and put it over here. That should help out. I guess we can bring it, let's bring it down to 10. I'm gonna bring all of them down to 10. We'll make it feel better, little buddies. Raise the ticket prices to 10 bucks for an adult and 5 bucks for a child. I feel like we are starting to get up there quite a bit, but that's okay. Space is still good. They want a little bit more climbable area. I think, like I said, as we come up with research, I think it might give us some prefabs that we can just throw in there and we'll be good to go. So we're working on the black bear right here. I think really what we have to do is just wait. At this point, we've just got to wait. We've got a fantastic new exhibit in the zoo. Gonna keep on making some money. Things are looking great for us, but we need to give it a little bit of time. So I'll see you guys in a sec. Oh no, there's a shelters and climbing option in our mechanic research. So we're gonna have to check that out. People still think the ticket prices are underpriced. I'm gonna do 12 and 6 then. Sounds good to me. I mean, I always like raising those prices. We have added some crocs and some bears and stuff like that though. So that's obviously gonna be make a pretty big difference. So their welfare is just not great. I guess, let me see, we might have a little bit unlocked just from normal research, enrichment items for the black bear. Yeah, we can do, let's do a rubbing pillar over in front of this window. Let's do a cardboard box, maybe up top. Might be kind of fun to watch them play with that. We could do a bamboo feeder over here next to their actual food. And then, I mean, we could do like little climbable things like this if we wanted. We could do a scent enrichment. I just hate when we add random stuff all throughout and it doesn't really make sense. Actually, you know what? This would make more sense up here. And then this down here where they can run around with it. So we're gonna put this herb scented thing up here. All right. Let's see how that works. Oh yeah, we're up to an 86% welfare. Really, the only thing is we need more climbable space. So your boy needs to get it together. I guess, hold on a second. I think I can problem solve this. Let me see this. I'm gonna come into habitat. We're gonna put this little thing here. We're gonna put a small one, very small, and then we're gonna raise it up a little bit. Keep it in line. Are those in line? Not really, hold on a second. We could go like that. And then what we could do is we could put, we can grab something else, maybe like a climbable log, but we're gonna want a long one, 4 meters, 6 meters. I feel like the thin ones might be kind of fun for them, a new type of challenge. So we're gonna bring this thing down, and then we're gonna curve it this way, and then we're gonna move it into place. Can we get it set up? I'm gonna have it so it goes all the way up there, and then we're gonna bring it down so it comes all the way to the ground, and it lines up. Does that line up? Kind of. Something like that. And then we could take this, we could bring this back here, and kind of set it up right like that. And then we could bring this, and set it up right where it goes right through it, right like that. But it's still gotta be in the ground though. So we gotta push this down the ground. Bring it back that way just a little bit. Boom, all right. Is that gonna count as climbable area? Now they got like another little way up there? No, okay. Well, forget I even tried. We're gonna have to figure that out eventually. But honestly, I really love how this turned out. I think we did a really, really good job. I think this is something a bit different. It's got a lot more going on. Like a lot of these guys all like a lot of open space and stuff like that. Oh! We've got a little baby African buffalo. No way. Already? I didn't even notice. Dude, time flies in this game. Do we have a baby? We have a baby over here? No, we might have a dead. Yeah, we've got a dead aardvark. So we're gonna have to buy some new aardvarks. I could have sworn she was pregnant. Maybe I'm crazy. But we've got to get some more aardvarks. We've got a puppy over here, I believe. Yep. Little puppy. So our breeding program is working. Oh, is this a second? This is a second puppy. We've got two puppies. We've got like a whole army of puppies sleeping back here. This is amazing. Are we doing okay? Yeah, they're still happy. They're not getting overcrowded. Of course, we've got our baby crocs as well. Where are they? You guys see them? Are they swimming? Oh, they're over here. Look at these little logs, man. Just hanging out, getting a nice little snack. They look angry. But yeah, we've got all that going on. And now, of course, we've got these two, which both seem to be pretty happy. Hopefully, that's going to lead to some mating. We do have to figure out some more climbable area for them. But overall, extremely solid episode. So hope you guys enjoyed. I'm going to see you guys in our next one. Let me know which animal you guys want to see next. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you all later. Peace out.